Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Well, if you've been keeping up with this one, you know that we just resealed this entire lower unit. But before I fill it with oil, I want to go ahead and pressure test it. Now, it's really simple to do. Let me go show you the tool that we're going to use. We'll get that done and then we'll finish it up for the day. The only special tool that we're going to need is just the pressure tester itself. So if you would, click the link in the description below. It'll have this part number that'll carry you to a cart where this is ready to go. Once yours has come in, we can go over there and I'll show you how to put it to use. We've got our pressure tester in hand. The only thing I need to do now is just lean it over a little bit to where I can get to that vent bolt or screw, if you will. Now keep in mind, to do this, it needs to be completely drained. So now would be a perfect time to do a quick test if you were changing out your lower gear oil. Now this one hasn't been filled yet after we did a series of seal and O-ring replacements. So now's the perfect time to do this. To make sure all the work that I did is gonna actually do the job. So we're just gonna put a 2x4 under this edge, and that should give us enough room. Let's pop it out. Now for the Mercury, we don't need any of the adapters, so it should go straight in. Now we're gonna take it up to about 12 PSI and just make sure it stays there. There's 12. We'll let it sit there for a couple of minutes, but I can go ahead and tell you, it's not gonna move. All right, guys, this is a really short video, but now you know how to make sure that your lower unit is sealed up and ready to go. Now, what would you do if it was losing pressure? Well, that's when you get some soapy water or some 409, anything that's gonna create bubbles, and spray it around your output shaft, input shaft, and your shift shaft, and that'll tell you which seals and or O-rings may need to be replaced on your unit. Now I'm pretty much done with this one. All I need to do now is drop it back down level, refill it with gear lube, and then remount it to the power head. Now if you need step-by-step instructions on how to do that, why don't you check the playlist for this particular outboard, and I'll be glad to walk you through the process. And hey, if you need any parts for your boat, come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.